Ago, in a village far, far away, there lived a poor miller and his beautiful daughter. Now it happened that the miller had to go and speak to the king. So he traveled to the kingdom with his message. In order to make himself appear more important, the miller told the king that his daughter could spin straw into gold. And this is where our story begins.
Enter.
Hello, King.
Hello.
I am the miller who lives down in the village, and I have a beautiful daughter who can spin straw into gold.
Really? This is great news. Bring her to me tomorrow morning, and we shall wed in 4 days' time.
Thank you.
See yourself out.
Yes, Your Highness. Hi, Bunny.
Hi.
Thank you for doing all of our laundry.
You're welcome.
I have some news for you today.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Tomorrow I will be taking you to the king. He wants to marry you.
Thank you. Now we'll be able to have all the things that we need in life.
Hello, King.
Hello, Miller. Is this your daughter?
Yes.
She is beautiful.
Will you take care of her?
Of course.
Thank you. Bye, sweetie. Bye, Father. I love you. Love you too.
Now that the king had the miller's daughter, he put her straight to work.
Do you see that straw right there? Your life depends on that being gold by tomorrow morning.
How am I supposed to turn this into gold?
The miller's daughter cried, for surely she was going to die. Then all of a sudden, a goblin appeared.
Why are you weeping, miller's daughter?
Well, the king said that I have to weave all the straw into gold by morning, or I'll die.
What will you give me if I spin all of it?
Well, I do have this.
The miller's daughter took off her necklace and gave it to the goblin in hopes that he would spin the straw into gold.
This will do. Now go to sleep while I spin the straw into gold.
Okay.
While the miller's daughter slept, the goblin got working.
Gosh, he did it.
Yes. Young Miller's daughter, you've done well.
Thank you.
Come with me, I have another room for you here. Now you will spin this room into gold by tomorrow morning, or you will die.
But...
Be quiet and do it.
What's the matter, Miller's daughter?
Now the king has made me do this room.
What will you give me if I spin it into gold for you?
Well,
the miller's daughter took off her ring and gave it to the goblin.
This will do. Now go and sleep while I spin it into gold.
Thank you. miller's daughter was excited to see the gold in the morning. But then the king entered the room.
Wow, you've impressed me. I have one more room for you, and if you can spin it into gold, you shall be my wife. This is the last room. Spin it to gold by tomorrow, and in the morning we will wed.
The king was a greedy man, and the miller's daughter hoped the goblin would show up again.
Why are you crying?
The king wants to marry me, but if I don't turn this into gold, then I'll die.
What will you give me if I spin this straw into gold?
Well, I don't have anything left.
Promise me your firstborn child.
Well, okay. It's probably not gonna happen, so okay.
Now rest your head while I spin this straw into gold.
Okay.
You have proved to me that you are a wealthy woman and you are worthy to be queen. We shall wed this afternoon. Come on.
The king and the miller's daughter were married, and a year later, the queen gave birth to her firstborn child, forgetting about the promise she had made to the goblin.
Hello, miller's daughter. Remember what we promised?
You can't have my baby.
But we had a deal, Queen.
Well, surely I could give you something. After all, I do have all the riches in the world.
But you promised your firstborn baby.
Please, no.
I'll give you 3 days to figure out what my name is. But if you don't, the baby is mine.
The Queen was horror-struck at the thought of losing her baby. So she thought the whole night of all the names that she had ever heard.
Hello, Queen! What is my name?
Is it Conrad?
No.
Is it Frederick?
No.
Is it Harry?
No. 2 more days until that baby is mine.
On the second day, the queen had inquiries made in the neighborhood as to the names of the people there.
Donkey Tail.
No. Sheepshanks.
Lace Leg.
No.
Balthazar.
Short Ribs.
No.
But none of those names were correct. There was only 1 more day until that goblin took her baby. On the 3rd day, the messenger set out to find a new name, but as she came to a high mountain, she saw a little house, and she peeked in. There she saw a fire burning, with a ridiculous little man jumping around and singing,
"Today I bake, tomorrow I brew, soon I'll have babies too. This is fun, I like this game, because Rumpelstiltskin is my name."
The messenger couldn't believe what she had just heard.
Rumpelstiltskin! The queen is going to be so happy!
She ran as fast as she could to the queen to report the news.
Queen! Queen! I went through the forest and I saw a house and I looked through it and I saw a little goblin and...
Little goblin thinks he can fool us. Well, he's got another thing coming. Rumpelstiltskin.
On the 3rd day, the goblin returned.
Hello, Miller's daughter. For surely that baby's gonna be mine, unless
to figure out my name.
Is it horseshoe?
No.
Or perhaps it's Rumpelstiltskin.
The devil took it out! The devil took it out!
Rumpelstiltskin ran into the forest and disappeared, never to be seen again.